Very good morning, children. Welcome to the psychology classroom. I hope you all are studying and doing well in your studies. Children, we are studying the chapter. So we are studying the chapter Psychology and Life, children, where we have studied about environmental psychology. We read about social psychology. We discuss about some of the related terms, the problem which are facing by the society, like poverty. So we read what is poverty, what are the causes of poverty, what are the consequences and the effects. Poverty humne padha. We read about aggression. We discuss about what are the causes of aggression as well as how we can reduce it. Today, from this chapter only, the topic which we are going to discuss about is health, which is also a very important part. Health. Health ki jab hum log baat karte hain bachcho, तो हेल्थ व्हेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस कंसेप्ट सो वी टॉक अबाउट द ओवरऑल एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ द हेल्थ सो इट्स नॉट ओनली फिजिकल बट वी शुड ऑल्सो टेक केयर ऑफ अवर साइकोलॉजिकल हेल्थ विच इज अवर मेंटल हेल्थ एंड राइट नाउ दिस इज इमर्जिंग एज जस्ट वेरी वास्ट एंड एवरीबडी is studying about the and very much concerned about their health. Don't misjudge the health with the looks. Looks is something which is the outward appearance of a person, but we should take care about our internal stability, internal equilibrium. That is a health. Our understanding about the health and well-being has undergone a major change in recent time. It is now conceded that various health outcomes are not only a function of disease, but the way we think and behave. So now the health is concerned with our thinking and behavior. Health is concerned our thinking and behavior. This finding reflected in the definition of health provided by WHO, World Health Organization, who defined that health include biological, psychological and social aspect. It focuses not only on physical but also on mental and spiritual aspect. We will concern ourselves with physical health, but we only concern more about the physical health only, physical aspect. But we most of the time ignore the social, mental and spiritual aspect of the health, which is equally important. So health and illnesses are a matter of degree. One may be suffering from a physically disabling disease but may be quite healthy otherwise. Yes, children, it happens. There are so many people who are having the disease, who are suffering from severe diseases, but they found to be very happy. You found them, they are always smiling because they are healthy from here. So being a physical healthiness is not enough. You maybe know the name of Baba Amte or Stephen Hawking. Both of them suffered from creeping disease. Unko disease the, but they have made greater contribution in their field. We also find that people differ across culture in their thinking about when and how people fall ill. and therefore in the model which they use in prevention of diseases and promotion of health. There are traditional culture like Chinese, Indian and Latin American who hold that good health result from the harmonious balance of various elements in the body. And ill health result when such a balance is lost. So, some of the countries, they may find that good health is a result of the harmonious balance. So, उन्होंने ये कहा कि good health is the result of harmonious balance. Harmonious balance, good health is the result of harmonious balance of various elements in the body. Various elements in the body. So good health क्या है? ये result है harmonious balance of various elements in the body. और health is not only limited to the physical aspect, but also social, mental and spiritual. Understood? But on the contrary, जो western culture होते हैं, they view health as a result of fully functioning machine which has no blockage. The different system of medicine developed in different cultures are based on these models. So for every in different cultures there are different kind of models which are explaining the concept of health. There's another fact that you know, the WHO report that in developing countries such as Asia, Africa, Latin America, more people die due to HIV, AIDS, TB, malaria or respiratory infection and nutritional deficiency. In the developed country, the leading causes are various cardiovascular diseases, cancers and psychiatric disorder. Such differences may be explained in terms of how this society are economically and socially structured. ठीक है, तो आप ये ज्यादातर find out करेंगे children, जैसे कि developed countries में ज्यादातर ये सारे diseases होते हैं. Psychiatric disorders बहुत ज्यादा, you may I think I have discussed with you so many times that in foreign countries, in the western countries, the psychological problems are more than in developing countries, than in India. Okay, so at the individual level, psychologists point to various factors such as health related formation, including attitude and belief, behavior and social factors which are associated with the physical well-being or illness. So out of this, so many researches have done and it has been found that the three things play a very important role in the health. What are the three things? I'm rubbing it with the hope you all have noted it down. So what are the three things, children, which is related to the health? So first is cognition, आपका thought pattern कैसा है, ये भी आपके health को determine करता है. Second, आपका behavior, अभी मैंने बताया thinking and behavior, that is cognition behavior. And third factor is the social and कल्चरल फैक्टर, ये भी डिटरमाइन करता है आपके हेल्थ को, आप किस तरह के सोशल एनवायरमेंट में रह रहे हैं, किस तरीके के आप इन कल्चर इन्वॉल्वमेंट पे रह रहे हैं, व्हाट काइंड ऑफ कल्चर यू आर लीविंग, या किस तरीके का कल्चर है आपका, किस तरीके का सोशल इन्वॉल्वमेंट है, ये भी बहुत डिटरमाइन करता है. सो लेट अस स्टडी वन बाय वन इट. सो फर्स्ट वी डिस्कस अबाउट द कॉग्निशन. ओके, फर्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द कॉग्निशन. यू मे हैव ऑब्जर्व सम पीपल आर क्विक टू सी डॉक्टर्स हेल्प while others do not. If they are suffering from symptoms such as nausea, cold, diarrhea, for example, fever, okay? So, ऐसा आपने I think observe किया हो रहा children कि कुछ लोग होते हैं बहुत जल्दी doctor के पास जाते हैं, बहुत से लोग नहीं जाते. The variation in seeking help are due to differences in mental representation people make relating to disease. मेंटल रिप्रेजेंटेशन पीपुल मेक रिलेटिंग टू द डिजीज, इट्स सीवियरिटी एंड द कॉज ऑफ डिजीज. वन मे नॉट सी डॉक्टर्स हेल्प फॉर अ कोल्ड इफ वन एट्रीब्यूट इट टू ईटिंग कर्ड और फॉर लेप्रोसी और स्मॉल पॉक्स इफ दीज आर एट्रीब्यूटेड टू गॉड्स एनॉइंट. द लेवल ऑफ अवेयरनेस और इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट डिजीज एंड बिलीव हाउ इट इज कॉज्ड and about possible way of relieving the distress or improving health effect, help seeking behavior as well as sticking to a doctor regimen. Another factor which influences our health seeking from a doctor is the perception of pain, which is a function of personality, anxiety and social norm. Simple सी बात है कि आप डॉक्टर के पास जा रहे हैं कि नहीं जा रहे हैं, the you are seeking the help of the doctor or not, it totally depend on your personality, it totally depend on the appraisal of the situation, how you are appraising the situation, how you are attributing the reason for your behavior, that determines a lot. Secondly, behavior. Health is also related to the behavior. It also have determined by the behavior. Behavior. Psychologists have found. So now after the cognition is the term behavior. Yes, health is very closely related to the behavior also. Psychologists have found a strong evidence which show that behavior we engage in and our lifestyle greatly influence health. Obviously children, it is very much true. हमारा behavior ही तो हमारे health को influence करता है, affect करता है. What kind of food you are taking, what kind of hobbies and pleasures you have, what is your daily routine, what the discipline you have in your life, that determine your health. People differ greatly in terms of behavioral risk factors भी होते हैं, जैसे smoking, tobacco use, alcohol and drug abuse, unsafe sexual behavior, diet and physical exercise. It is well accepted now that such behavior are associated with incidence of CHD, which is full form is coronary heart disease, cancer, HIV, besides many other diseases. A new discipline called behavioral medicine has emerged which seeks to alleviate stress due to disease through modification in behavior. See children, our physical health is very much related to our psychological health. If you are susceptible to any kind of disease, it will give you stress. Your psychological well-being directly get affected. So obviously it has a very closely connection with your health. After the behavior, the another factor which determines the health is social and cultural factor. Yeah, social, I mean the social environment in which you are living, the cultural environment in which you are living, that also determine your health. Come under the social and cultural factor. There is now a growing body of research which shows that social and cultural differences may influence our physiological responses and may not be the same across all culture. For example, the relationship between hostility and anger and CSD is not found to be the same in all culture. What is the relationship between heart disease? What is the relationship between anger and hostility with the heart disease? ये सभी culture में ये जैसा नहीं है. While interaction between culture and physiological responses require more evidence, Social and cultural norm associated with roles and gender greatly influence our health behavior. In Indian society, medical advice by or for a female is often delayed because of various reasons. They are less valued or because of the belief that they are hardy or the shame associated with the disease. Yes, children, I can say that these factors are also responsible for the well-being and the health. In some of the culture where the women are considered as an inferior and they are not so valued, they are not so respected, they are not taken into consideration, importance. So whatever the disease they are having, the people do not find it very importance to it. Usually in that kind of society, in that kind of culture, the male, if male person is having any kind of disease, they are going to be treated very soon as compared to the woman. उनका इलाज वे लोग बहुत जल्दी कराते हैं इन कंपेरिजन टू दी वुमेन. सो कल्चर फैक्टर ऑल्सो डिटरमाइन द हेल्थ. ओके, सो हियर वी हैव अंडरस्टैंड अबाउट द हेल्थ इन डिटेल. वी हैव अंडरस्टैंड हाउ हेल्थ हैज एन इफेक्ट. तो हेल्थ इज डिटरमाइंड बाय द थ्री इम्पॉर्टेंट फैक्टर, दैट इज अ कॉग्निशन विच इज थिंकिंग. It is also determined by the behavior as well as some of the social and cultural factor. So mostly we have discussed about health. Now the next and the last topic which we have to discuss in this chapter is the impact of television on behavior. Impact of television. हमें television के impact को भी discuss करना है. सो इम्पैक्ट ऑफ टेलीविजन जो टॉपिक है हमारा, फर्स्ट आई विल राइट इट डाउन. एज यू ऑल नो द टेलीविजन बेसिकली इट इज अ मॉनिटर विच इज प्रोड्यूसिंग अ रेज विच आर ऑब्वियसली नॉट गुड फॉर द आईज ऑफ द पर्सन ऑफ द चाइल्ड एंड द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट दिस हैव अ फिजिकल इफेक्ट विच आई एम टेलिंग यू. The point which I am discussing you right now, that was related to the physical aspect only, but it has a psychological aspect also. It has a vast effect on the human behavior. Human behavior pe bhi iska effect hota hai. How it has an effect on the human behavior? Obviously the things which you watch, the content which you saw on the television, okay, that have an effect. ठीक है, उसका इफेक्ट हो सकता है. देयर इज नो डाउट दैट टेलीविजन हैज बीन अ यूजफुल प्रोडक्ट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजिकल प्रोग्रेस. हाउएवर फ्रॉम द पॉइंट ऑफ इट्स साइकोलॉजिकल इम्पैक्ट ऑन ह्यूमन बीइंग, both positive and negative effects have been observed. Many research studies have inquired into the effects of television viewing on cognitive processes and social behavior, especially in Western culture. तो वेस्टर्न कल्चर में, इन वेस्टर्न कल्चर ये देखा गया है कि टेलीविजन का इम्पैक्ट कॉग्निटिव प्रोसेसेस और सोशल बिहेवियर पे होता है. Western culture give emphasis on the cognitive processes and social behavior. This finding show a missed impact. Most of the research study have been carried out on children because they are seen as being more vulnerable to the impact of television rather than adult. So what are the effect of television? Firstly, we discuss first one. सबसे पहला क्या है, व्हाट इज द फर्स्ट वन? फर्स्ट, टेलीविजन प्रोवाइड अ लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ इंफोटेनमेंट. यू नो द मीनिंग ऑफ इन्फो. इंटरटेनमेंट मीन्स एलिमेंट ऑफ जॉय. सो इंफोटेनमेंट मीन्स एलिमेंट ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन. इज एन अट्रैक्टिव फॉर्म एंड इन द विजुअल मोड फॉर विच इट बिकम पावरफुल मीडियम ऑफ इंस्ट्रक्शन. एट द सेम टाइम, बिकॉज द प्रोग्राम्स आर अट्रैक्टिव, children spend huge amount of time watching them. This reduces their habit of reading, writing and also their outdoor activity. So isme kya kiya hai, it reduce outdoor activity. Sabse pehle to television ne outdoor activities ko reduce kar diya hai. Bacche bahar nahi jaate, ghar mein they used to sit at one place and just focus their eye on a box, not going outside. No motor movement will be there, no physical exercise will be there, which will ultimately affect their health. So reduce the outdoor activities, reading and writing habits. Reading, earlier the people used to, I think children, see, if any innovation came or if any new thing comes, so for everything, whether it is old or new, everything has a negative as well as positive impact. Har ek cheez ka ek negative aur positive dono impact hota hai. Theek hai, I think you might have heard that when there was no television, when there was no TV, when there is no media, what the children usually do? They read the books. वो बुक उनके पास होते थे. They have the availability of the different kind of stories, books, and interesting books, story books, rhyming books, and the children used to read it. They write something, they draw something, they used to go outside and play with their friends, they jump, they race, they walk, they play, they cycling, they do so many outdoor activities. But because of this television, the people used to sit at one place, no physical exercise done, no outdoor activities done, reading as well as writing habits are also reduced. So this is the first impact of television on the behavior. What is the second? This is the first point, second point. Second, television watching may have an effect on children's ability to concentrate on one target and their creativity and ability to understand and also their social interaction. So television का किस पे effect हुआ? चाइल्ड की एबिलिटी टू कंसंट्रेट ऑन वन टारगेट, देयर क्रिएटिविटी और एबिलिटी टू अंडरस्टैंड. तो इसमें क्या चीजों को अफेक्ट किया, क्रिएटिविटी को अफेक्ट ऑन क्रिएटिविटी, क्रिएटिविटी को अफेक्ट किया अंडरस्टैंडिंग या कॉम्प्रिहेंडिंग एबिलिटी को अफेक्ट किया, क्रिएटिविटी अंडरस्टैंडिंग एबिलिटी. ठीक है, एफेक्ट ऑन अटेंशन कंसंट्रेशन इन सारी चीजों को अफेक्ट किया. सो चिल्ड्रन डिड यू अंडरस्टैंड द सेकेंड एफेक्ट ऑफ द टेलीविजन, हाउ डज इट अफेक्टिंग द चाइल्ड. दे बट एवरीथिंग हैव सम पॉजिटिव एस्पेक्ट एज वेल एज नेगेटिव. सो इन दिस केस ऑल्सो देर आर एक्सीलेंट प्रोग्राम ऑल्सो डेट इम्प्रिसाइज पॉजिटिव इंटरपर्सनल एटीट्यूड एंड प्रोवाइड यूजफुल फैक्चुअल इंफॉर्मेशन. टीचिंग चिल्ड्रेन हाउ टू डिजाइन एंड कंस्ट्रक्ट सर्टन ऑब्जेक्ट. ऑन द अदर हैंड दीज प्रोग्राम में distract young reviewers and interfere with their ability to concentrate on one target. See, television provides so many factual information also and as well as so many useful information also, but still it will have an effect on the child concentration level. It made the child distracted, okay, it made the child to be less focused toward their studies. Third, what is the third impact of television on behavior? What is the third impact of television on behavior? What is the third impact? Third, about 40 years ago, a serious debate was raised in the USA and Canada regarding the effect of television viewing on aggressiveness and violence among the viewer. And it was discussed that, and the result of research showed that watching violence on television indeed lead to greater aggressiveness in the viewer. And if the viewers were children, they tend to imitate what they saw. आपने बहुत से बच्चों को देखा होगा, if they saw the WWF, so they also start fighting with like that one. If they saw any kind of super natural power, a person who is having the supernatural power and they fly in the sky, so they also want to fly, and it will be very injurious on the part of the children. So television also has the third impact. It increases aggression and violence, the tendency of aggression and violence. ये aggression और violence भी increase किया है बच्चों में, because children बहुत they are very close observer, they are very keen observer, and they usually learn so many things by observing others. Now research shows that if the viewer were children, they tend to imitate what they saw. They were not mature enough to think of the consequence of such behavior. However, some other study pointed out that merely watching violence on the television does not make children more aggressive. Other factors are also there to be present in the situation. One finding has shown that watching violence may actually reduce the natural aggressive tendency of the viewer. Yeah, इससे natural aggressive tendency भी view, जिससे जो natural tendency है वो कम हो जाती है. ठीक है, what is bottled up gets an outlet and thus clean the system like a choked drain pipe being cleaned. And this process is called catharsis. इसी process को catharsis कहते हैं. ठीक है, Now, fourth, what is the fourth effect of television on behavior? In case of adult as well as children, it is said that a consumerist attitude has developed, and this is due to television watching. Numerous products are advertised, and it is very natural for the viewer to get carried away. No matter, ठीक है? So what is the fourth one? Consumerist attitude. इसका एक और इफेक्ट होता है कि हमारे में एक कंज्यूमरिस्ट एटीट्यूड आ जाता है. सो दीज आर सम ऑफ द इंपैक्ट ऑफ टेलीविजन ऑन बिहेवियर चिल्ड्रन. सो दिस इज फॉर ऑल टुडे एंड हियर वी हैव कंप्लीटेड अवर चैप्टर 8 साइकोलॉजी एंड लाइफ. आई होप यू ऑल आर वॉचिंग द वीडियो. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर केयरफुली लिसनिंग एंड वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो. थैंक यू.